Hi there. In today's video, we're going to take a dive into DeFi to understand what is SushiSwap. Although it might sound like a place where you go and swap different types of sushi with other people, I can assure you, it has nothing to do with food. Rather, SushiSwap is actually a decentralized exchange that's been around for quite some time now and that has managed to build up quite the following. What makes it special, though, and why would you use it over other popular names in the industry, such as Uniswap? Well, the two DEXs actually have much more in common than you think. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Welcome to Crypto Finally Explained, the most crypto-friendly educational YouTube channel for actually learning crypto. Here, I finally explain crypto topics using simple animations, visual doodles, and real-life examples, so no matter if you're 5 or 75, you'll be able to understand it. In this video, we will work our way through getting a better understanding of what is SushiSwap, as well as discussing its currently available and past features. In particular, we will answer common questions like how does SushiSwap work, which features has it developed, and what network is SushiSwap on? Let's not waste any time and get right into it. First things first, what is SushiSwap? Well, think of it as a platform that allows you to swap one cryptocurrency for another. It's like a digital marketplace for these virtual currencies. In other words, SushiSwap, usually referred to as Sushi, is a crypto exchange, just like many other projects we've talked about in previous videos. Still, what sets Sushi apart from traditional exchanges is its decentralized nature. Now, let me paint a picture. Imagine you're in a bustling market where vendors are swapping different items. In this market, each vendor is a user and the items are various cryptocurrencies. The market operates without a central authority overseeing every trade, and that's the essence of SushiSwap. Unlike a traditional market with a boss managing everything, SushiSwap is like a collective bazaar where everyone contributes. In other words, unlike centralized exchanges where a central authority controls everything, Sushi is more of a community-driven organization. Now, let's take some time to understand this decentralized exchange, or DEX, better. Oh, and if you want to learn more about the differences between Texas and Texas, be sure to check out my dedicated video on the topic. So, how does SushiSwap work? When you trade on Sushi, you're not directly swapping with another trader. You're trading with liquidity pools. And here's the neat part. When you contribute to a pool, you earn from the fees that it employs. That's right, as a liquidity provider, you become a part of the SushiSwap community and get rewarded for it. In exchange for providing liquidity to pools, you receive SushiSwap Liquidity Provider, or SLP, tokens. But don't worry, we'll talk more about liquidity pools and SushiSwap LP tokens later. Now, let's get to another common question. What is SushiSwap built on? Or, in other words, what chain is SushiSwap on? Well, Sushi is an Ethereum-based DEX. That's because the Ethereum network provides a secure and decentralized backdrop, allowing everyone to engage in the world of DeFi through different dApps. Still, Sushi has expanded its operations to multiple chains. Lastly, there's one more aspect of Sushi that I should mention. It's decentralized governance. The entire platform is designed to give Sushi token holders a say in major changes and updates through voting, thus ensuring a democratic process. However, the day-to-day operations, rebalancing of pools, business strategy, and overall development are handled by the core team. In a nutshell, SushiSwap is a DEX using automated market makers and liquidity pools. It's not just a place to trade. It's a community where you can contribute, earn, and explore the world of decentralized finance. Now, let's talk about Sushi's features. But before that, are you enjoying the video so far? If so, be sure to give it a like and subscribe to my channel so you won't miss out on future crypto explanatory uploads. Now, on to SushiSwap's main function, swapping. The heart of SushiSwap is its automated market maker, or AMM, model. This may sound complex, but it's pretty cool. Instead of relying on order books like traditional exchanges, Sushi uses liquidity pools. These pools are filled with cryptocurrency by users like you and me and are one of the main components of most DEXs. By the way, here's a fun fact. Did you know that SushiSwap looked almost identical to Uniswap when it launched back in 2020? That's because SushiSwap is actually a code fork of Uniswap. If you want to learn more about Uniswap, you can watch my video on it and try to spot all the differences and similarities between these two DEXs. Now that so much time has passed and both platforms have developed new features, the SushiSwap versus Uniswap conundrum is not that important anymore. After all, choosing which DEX to engage with is up to your own preferences and investment needs. But let's not strain further away from the main topic. Nowadays, Sushi offers multi-chain swapping across 7 networks: Base, Arbitrum, Optimism, Polygon, Avalanche, BNB Chain, and Ethereum, of course. You can seamlessly swap tokens across these supported chains without any fuss. Besides that, Sushi also has introduced payload executors. Have you ever found yourself stuck because you didn't have enough tokens for gas fees on the destination chain? Well, payload executors are meant to show up and save the day. They seek to streamline transaction capabilities and make swaps more convenient by charging fees on the source chain, eliminating the need for extra steps and gas tokens. Still, why are all these swapping features relevant? Well, that's because they allow people to find new tokens on multiple chains and that haven't reached Texas yet. This, in turn, helps investors to diversify their crypto portfolios. It's all about making crypto trading smoother and more diverse. Still, be sure to do your own research before engaging with not-so-established crypto projects, of course. Investing in them can be risky. Moving on, let's talk about those liquidity pools I've mentioned a few times throughout the video. Liquidity pools are a key component of most DEXs, and SushiSwap is no exception to that. But what are liquidity pools exactly? Well, they're a mechanism designed to enable crypto swapping by working as a reserve for buyers and sellers. They're not your average swimming pools. They're more like a group fund where people toss in their assets. To illustrate why liquidity pools are so essential, imagine you wanted to swap Ethereum for SushiSwap tokens. To do that, you'd deposit your ETH. But how could you instantly withdraw your deserved sushi if there wasn't a reserve of sushi already in place? That's where liquidity pools come in. They enable the swapping platform to send you the funds you bought. In case you want to know more about this, check out my dedicated video on liquidity pools. Anyways, SushiSwap uses these pools to collect liquidity in a way that's open and decentralized. No need to deal with big shot market makers or confusing order books. It's like a financial get-together where everyone has a say. Now, let's talk about the real stars of the show, the liquidity providers. When you deposit your assets into a pool, you become a liquidity provider. Each pool is connected to a crypto pair, and for your help, you get a bit of the fees charged on every trade made with that pair. Sweet deal, right? But here's the kicker. You also get the SushiSwap LP tokens I mentioned earlier. SLPs represent your share of a liquidity pool and can be used to harvest even more yield in a farm. By adding funds to the pool, you're helping fellow traders, and in return, you earn some rewards. It's a win-win for everyone involved. But hey, let's not ignore the elephant in the room. Providing liquidity comes with a dose of risk. Your tokens might waltz up and down in value as trades happen. Still, you can play it a bit safer by choosing pairs that move together, like USDT or USDC. Now, what can you do with the SLP rewards you get from being a liquidity provider? Well, you can trade them for other crypto, of course. But you can also stake at Sushi's liquidity pools to get even more rewards and even more Sushi tokens. What is that exactly? Well, Sushi is your key to governance within the SushiSwap ecosystem. To vote on changes, you either have to deposit Sushi in the Sushi ETH pool or stake it in the Sushi bar. So, what is that exactly? The Sushi bar is essentially a feature within the broader Sushi ecosystem. Its primary purpose is to allow users to stake their Sushi tokens, receiving X Sushi in return. Think of XSushi as a representation of your staked sushi tokens within the sushi bar. What's unique about being an XSushi holder? Well, it grants you a share of the trading fees generated on the sushi platform. This revenue-sharing mechanism is designed to reward users for their participation in the protocol. Try to imagine this as a loyalty program in a local coffee shop. You have your regular customers, the sushi stakers, and the coffee shop rewards them with a special stock, XSushi, which grants them a share of the earnings every time someone buys a cup of coffee or trades on SushiSwap. It's a way to give back to the loyal patrons. To delve deeper, let's explore the revenue sharing process. In Sushi V2, a 0.3% trading fee is applied to each transaction. Out of this, 0.25% goes to liquidity providers, or LPs, as a reward for supplying liquidity, and the remaining 0.05% is directed to the Sushi bar for redistribution among ex-Sushi holders. This 0.05% fee is utilized to buy back Sushi from the open market. The acquired sushi is then distributed proportionately to ex-sushi holders based on their stake in the sushi bar. This cyclical process ensures a continuous flow of rewards to ex-sushi holders. It's the coffee shop not only giving loyalty points, but also buying a round of drinks for its most loyal customers. The sushi bar operates within the governance structure known as Sushi Power, granting voting power to ex-sushi holders. This empowers them to actively participate in decision-making processes, influencing the platform's direction. It's like having the VIP patrons voting on the changes to the coffee shop menu. In conclusion, the Sushi Bar offers users a mechanism to stake their sushi tokens, earning X sushi and a share of the platform's trading fees. This involvement not only provides a continuous cycle of reward distribution, but also bestows governance participation and decision-making power upon X sushi holders. Now then, let's talk about some features that have been put to a halt. Some changes have taken place in the SushiSwap landscape. Two key players, Kashi and Miso V2, have taken a step back, and I want to keep you in the loop. First up, Kashi 1.0, a lending and margin trading platform that allows you to create your own lending markets. If you've been navigating the Kashi UI, you may notice a shift. Deposits and borrows in the Kashi 1.0 UI have been disabled. SushiSwap claims the UI will stick around, but the markets won't be actively maintained. So, the suggestion here is to withdraw or repay your positions if you've got any hanging around. But why the shift in focus? Well, as part of SushiSwap roadmap makeover and a need to prioritize their DEX stack, resources have been reallocated from Kashi. It's not a goodbye forever though. Kashi just won't be a priority for a while until more resources can be allocated. Now, let's talk MISO V2, the feature that sought to simplify the launch of new projects into multiple ecosystems. While the MISO UI will keep its virtual doors open, active maintenance is taking a backseat for the same reason that nudged Kashi into the shadows. Still, these two features seem to just be taking a break as resources are allocated to other projects inside the Sushi ecosystem. And that's it! Today, we've taken a comprehensive look into SushiSwap and its features. I hope you've enjoyed the journey and learned a thing or two about this decentralized exchange. As you venture into the DeFi landscape, keep in mind that Sushi is all about empowering the community. It's like a bustling marketplace where your crypto can mingle and do some profitable networking. Whether you're a seasoned crypto enthusiast or just dipping your toes into decentralized waters, SushiSwap offers a unique blend of innovation and community-driven spirit. Thank you for watching this video on SushiSwap. I hope you found it valuable and that it will help you feel like a fish in the DeFi sea. If you like this animated explainer, make sure to give it a thumbs up, comment, and subscribe to Crypto Finally Explained. See you soon!